Christmas period, because obviously I've had quite a bit of time sitting at my mother's and no internet, well, apart from my mobile phone, and so I've had quite a bit of time to kill, so I have been reading quite a lot. So I thought I would just show you the books that I have read over Christmas and give you a brief outline of my thoughts. I might have shown you these books before Christmas because I bought them, some of them anyway, on a trip to North Wales, to a little town called London. And I'm going to show them to you in the order that I read them. So here's the first one. His daughter, and he and his wife go try to find her, and yeah, a little bit of a twist at the end there, and I quite enjoyed it, but as I said, having read quite a few by this author, you realise there is sort of a similar thread through all of them, but nonetheless, I did enjoy it. Sound a little different to normal. But let's get on to the next book that I read. And again, came from a charity shop. And I paid £1. I really enjoyed this book. fresh as tomorrow. That doesn't tell you anything about the book, but I was intrigued and I loved it. Took me a few days, so it wasn't really a page turner, but it was one that I really enjoyed. And essentially it's about a family run laundry in the East End of London, and a guy inherited the business from his mother, and he is now coming up to retirement and he wants to hand it over, and he takes on an apprentice, and the idea is that the apprentice learns the trade and then buys the business off him. And woven in amongst all of that gentle sort of a storyline are all of the artifacts and the customers who come into the shop and their lives, and a little bit of a flashback to his mother when she sort of started the laundry. So it was a little quirky, but I did enjoy it. So that is definitely one to recommend. Now, I have saved the best book, I think anyway, that I have read over Christmas. I've saved it till last. And I bet a few of you have read this book, because I heard a lot about it 2022, and I know there is also a film that came out in the cinema during 2022. I haven't seen the film. I deliberately avoided seeing it until I read the book. Now, the reason for that, when I read a book, I'm sure you're the same. You build up a picture of the how the characters look and the settings and all the little subplots that go on, and then when you go to the cinema, they often strip out a lot of the little details. Well, they have to sort of condense the book into a film, but I always feel a little cheated if I sort of read the book and then see the film. So I wanted to enjoy the book and get all the details, so I avoided seeing the film. Have you guessed which book I'm talking about? I paid full price for this. I haven't found it in a charity shop yet. I bought it from Amazon. So much more in the book about this young girl who kind of grows up alone in this sort of swampland in North Carolina, and her coming of age really, and again, gorgeous, gorgeous writing. I really enjoyed it. And of course at the end you find out killed. celebration of nature. The Daily Mail, unforgettable, as engrossing as it is moving. If you haven't read it and you enjoy books, it's a big recommendation from me. So far.